Hi, good morning. Welcome to SSV IIT classes. I am Basha, faculty of Maths. So, today we are going to discuss about the compound angles, 6th class. In previous class, we discussed about the sin A plus B into sin A minus B and cos A plus B into cos A minus B. The next one is tan of A plus B into tan of A minus B. Already we know the formula of tan of A plus B into tan of A minus B. So, by substituting the values of tan of A plus B, tan A plus tan B by 1 minus tan A tan B. So this is about the tan of A plus B formula. So tan of A minus B formula, tan A minus tan B by 1 plus tan A tan B. Observe the two identities. In numerator both are in product. Tan A plus B, tan A plus tan B, tan A minus tan B means which are in the form of A plus B into A minus B form. So the result is A square minus B square. By using this identity, both in numerator and denominator we have same formula. 1 minus tan A tan B, 1 plus tan A tan B. So by using this identity, we can write as tan A tan B means tan square A minus tan square B by, so in denominator, 1 minus A square minus B square. B square means tan square A into tan square B. So this is the condition. So we cannot simplify it. Then the next one is tan of pi by 4 plus A. So it is in the form of tan of A plus B. So by expanding it, tan A means tan pi by 4 plus tan B means A here. Tan A by 1 minus tan pi by 4 into tan A. So we know the values of pi by 4. Pi by 4 means 45 degrees. 45 degrees. Tan 45 degrees value 1. So by substituting its value, 1 plus tan A by 1 minus 1 into tan A. 1 into tan A. So by writing the tan A as sin A by cos A, we can simplify more. 1 plus tan A value sin A by cos A. By denominator, we will get 1 minus tan A value sin A by cos A. By taking cos A in numerator and denominator, we will get the value as cos A as LCM in numerator, cos A into 1 cos A. Cos A plus sin A by, in denominator also we will take cos as LCM, so cos A minus sin A by cos A. By cancelling cos cos, we will get the final answer as cos A plus sin A by cos A minus sin A, which is equal to tan pi by 4 plus A. Similarly, for tan pi by 4 minus A also we can write an identity. Here I am writing tan pi by 4 minus A, same formula using tan A minus B form, minus plus, same as it is simplification, we will get finally cos A minus sin A by cos A plus sin A. So by using the above expansion, using tan A plus B and tan A minus B form, so we will find these values. Okay, the next one is sin of A plus B plus C. Observe, we added only sin of A plus B form, only sin of A minus B form, cos of A plus B form, cos of A minus B form. Here we are adding three angles, A plus B plus C. Means, what is the value of sin A plus B plus C? By using the sin A plus B form, so I am dividing it as A plus B is one term and C is second term. Means, it is A, it is B. By using sin A plus B form, sin A plus B formula, sin A, I am writing here identity, sin of A plus B formula, sin A cos B plus cos A sin B. So I am applying here, A means sin A plus B, cos B means cos C plus cos A means A plus B and sin C. Sin A cos B, cos A sin B. And again we have using original identity sin a plus b. Sin a cos b plus cos a sin b into we have cos c plus cos a plus b form. Cos a cos b minus sin a sin b into sin c. By multiplying the cos a with the first term, sin c with the next term. So we get the value of sin a cos b cos c. Sin a cos b cos c. And again plus cos a sin b cos c. Plus the next term, sin c with the first term. Cos a cos b sin c minus all are sine, sin a sin b sin c. Observe the expansion. Sin a remaining two are cos, sin b remaining two are cos, sin c remaining two are cos. Means sin function is consecutively changing the a b c. So these are all we can write as summation minus these are all same sin a sin b sin c. What is the summation? Means observe here, pi means sum of, I think you know that, sigma means sum of, pi means product of, product of. For example, I am writing sigma a. What is mean by sigma a? We are using compound angles means a plus b plus c. R pi a means pi means product of pi a b c. Here sigma sin a means we can write as sin a plus sin b plus sin c and so on. Here I am writing it is as sigma first term, any one of the term in these three consecutive terms, sin a cos b cos c minus the second term is sin a sin b sin c. So these three terms I am writing in the form of summation of sin a cos b cos c. And the next one is cos of a plus b plus c form. Say by using same this identity, a plus b taken as a and c will be b, cos of a plus b form. So we know cos of a plus b form, here we wrote cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. By using cos a means a plus b, cos b means cos c minus sin a means sin of a plus b into sin b means sin c, b value c. By again expanding the cos of a plus b form, cos a cos b minus sin a sin b into cos c minus sin a cos b sin a plus b expansion plus cos a sin b into sin c. So again multiplying the first term with cos c, we will get cos a cos b cos c, all are cos, minus sin a sin b cos c, sin a sin b cos c minus sin c with the second term, sin a cos b sin c, sin a cos b sin c minus into plus minus again cos a sin b sin c, cos a sin b sin c. Observe the terms which are from except cos a cos b, remaining all are have negative sign. And observe the cos, cos c in the place of c, cos b in the place of b, cos a in the place of a, remaining are two sign, sin sin sin. So by using what we wrote in the above expansion, we can write as summation of cos, cos a cos b cos c minus sigma. Observe, we can write any one of the terms in these three. I am writing the cos a sin b sin c, any one of these three terms you can write. This is the cos of a plus b plus c using the cos a plus b form. this is sin of a plus b plus c using the sin a plus b form. And the first two are what we discussed in previous class, tan a plus b into tan a minus b, which is in the form of sin a plus b into sin a minus b. So by expanding the two identities and multiplying using the a plus b into a minus b form, it will be equal to a square minus b square. Then the result is numerator also, denominator also containing the same identity. So this is the final result for tan a plus b into tan a minus b. And then tan pi by 4 plus a, the value is in radians, pi by 4 value is radians. We know that 0 degrees means 0, we can write as 0 radians. And 30 degrees is equal to pi by 6 radians. 45 degrees is equal to pi by 4. 60 degrees is equal to pi by 3. 90 degrees is equal to pi by 2. 180 degrees is equal to pi. So and so on, you can calculate using these radians to degrees. So here we have pi by 4 value. Pi by 4 means 45 degrees. Tan 45 value 1. So tan a plus b form, tan a plus tan b by 1 minus tan a tan b. Tan pi by 4 value 1. 1 plus tan a by 1 minus tan a. Then tan a will be written as sin by cos. By taking LCM cos, we will get the this expansion. Similarly, we will find tan of pi by 4 minus a. So we will get the opposite side to the previous expansion. This is about the tan a plus b into tan a minus b. In next class, we are going to discuss about the some more terms using a plus b plus c is equal to 180 or a plus b is equal to 45. Then what are the conditions? Thank you.